It is done.
Johnson is dead?
No. He retreated when we destroyed the tea.
Only to hatch some new scheme, I'm sure. You should have killed him.
There was no need.
Time will tell if you speak the truth.
Radun Hagedum! Radun Hagedum!
Ganondokon, why are you here? Has something happened?
William Johnson has returned with all the money required to buy our land. He meets with the elders as we speak. I have begged him to resist, but I fear he shall have his way unless you intervene.
How is this possible? We destroyed the tea.
The Templars are nothing if not resourceful. You should have heeded my warning.
Please, you have to stop him.
Of course. Can you tell me where they're meeting?
Izzy not gonna daradit canus de ne Johnson's unjat the Rokstha. Guahigansi what neganun haradun hagedum.
The guadered hard at guacanto.
You seek land, true enough. Land that is not yours nor any person.
We are all too aware of the expeditions your people send against us.
How? By signing our lands over to you? Then we'll be as one in your debt forever?
Sir William may have a point. What hope have we against their black powder and iron?
The spirits will guide us.
Did they not guide us here?
Yes. That we might unmask the great betrayer.
This is a mistake. We should sign.
Peace, peace. Have I not always been an advocate? Have I not always sought to protect you from harm?
If you wish to protect us, then give us arms, muskets and horses that we might defend ourselves.
War is not the answer.
We remember, Stanwix. We remember you moved the borders. Even today, your men dig up the land, showing no regard for those who live upon it. Your words are honeyed, but false. We are not here to negotiate, nor to sell. We are here to tell you and yours to leave these lands.
So be it. I offered you an olive branch, and you knocked it from my hand. Perhaps you'll respond better to the sword.
Are you threatening us?
Yes.
Thought you might send one of your own to hold me. Runway in position. Now burn.
All up your dog, everyone dies!
Done.
Ensured an end to your schemes. You sought to claim these lands for the Templars.
Aye, that we might protect them. Do you think that good King George lies awake at night, hoping that no harm comes to his native subjects? Or that the people of the city care one whit about them? Oh, sure. The colonists are happy to trade when they need food or shelter, or a bit of extra padding for their armies. But when the walls of the city constrict, when there's crops that need soil, when there's no more enemy to fight, we'll see how kind the people are then.
The colonists have no quarrel with the Iroquois.
Not yet, but they will. 'Tis the way of the world. In time, they'll turn. I could have stopped it. I could have saved you all.
You speak of salvation, but you were killing them.
Aye, because they would not listen. And so, it seems, neither will you.
I was neyate hagumsare am dahyayum neskanas izagumhaja.
William Johnson is dead, and with him, the Templar plot to steal the land of my people. But in ending this threat, I have revealed another. On his body was a letter addressed to John Pitcairn containing orders to root out and destroy Patriot weapons and supply. Should he succeed in this, the colonists will be unable to maintain their resistance, and the Templars will surely take control. So long as Pitcairn lives, the danger remains. I need to find him. He needs to die. I thought it might bring clarity or instill a sense of accomplishment, but all I feel is regret.
Hold fast to that. Such sacrifices must never come lightly.
I had to do it. Not only for my people, but for all the others Johnson would have harmed.
It's a start. But to truly be free of Templar influence, all of them must be dealt with in turn. Even your father.
I know.
You speak the words, but do you believe them? Seems we've company.
What is it?
A request for aid from Paul Revere. Seems the Redcoats are up to something in Boston. Guess you made an impression on the Sons of Liberty.
They mistake me for one of their own. Please tell Mr. Revere he has my sympathies, but I cannot help at present.
You might wish to reconsider. John Pitcairn is mentioned by name.
Where am I to go?
Mr. Revere's house in Boston. If you'd like, I can...
Ah, Connor! What a relief! You came! Allow me to introduce you to William Dawes and Robert Newman.
Your letter said John Pitcairn was here.
Aye. He's readying an assault on Lexington, where Adams and Hancock have taken shelter. After that, he will march on Concord, hoping to destroy our weapons and supplies. You must help us.
Only tell me where to find him, and I will put a stop to this.
He has dozens, if not hundreds, of soldiers at his command. Cannot hope to match him by yourself. But fear not, for you will not have to. We have an entire army of our own, merely awaiting the order to take up arms.
Then you must call upon them.
Indeed. You and I. Cross the Charles River and rouse the boys. William, I need you to take the overland route and do the same. Robert, I need you up in Christchurch. Light the signal. Two lanterns, our enemy comes by sea.
No time for dawdling, my friend. We have lives to save. Come on. They've only left a single horse. We'll have to ride together. Ah! You take the reins, I'll navigate. Quickly, Connor, get on the horse! I'll guide you towards those we need to alert. Follow my directions, and we'll be done in no time. This way, Connor! Yes! This is it! This is the way! Yes! This is it! This is the way! Redcoats. What are they doing here?
They must be scouts.
Oh, bother. Everything looks the same at night. Be careful, Connor. We mustn't let them warn the others. Left! Go right, Connor! This way, Connor! Might be safer if we approach the houses on foot. This is it! You have got the right place! Let everyone know that the regulars marched for Lexington and Concord!
The British are coming!
Back in the saddle, my friend! We have more people to warn! Excellent! We are right on course! Excellent! We are right on course! Yes! This is it! This is the way! Be on the lookout for redcoats. Keep going! Might be safer if we approach the houses on foot. This is it! You have got the right place! Spread the word. The regulars are coming out.
At once!
Here we are. Best to continue on foot. This is it. You have got the right place. The regulars are coming.
Here. We're here. Get them!
We've got to shake those redcoats. Faster! We need to get away from them! We've got to shake those redcoats! Faster! We need to get away from them! That was much too close for comfort. Let us take care to avoid any further surprises. Here we are. Best to continue on foot. This is it. You have got the right place. Where the devil is he?
Are you sure we are in the right place?
Well, sure, I'm sure. Prescott?
Evening, gents.
Listen, the regulars are out. You need to rally your men. And, put on some trousers.
At once.
Welcome to Lexington, Connor. Now let's find Hancock and Adams. No sign of Dawes. I hope he's all right.
Paul, Connor, good to see you.
You need to leave. The Redcoats are coming.
Aye, so Williams told us. Let them conduct their little search. They'll find nothing.
You don't understand. Pitcairn intends to kill you.
I'm afraid it's true.
I suppose we have no choice then but to go. What of you three?
Dawes and I will continue on to Concord. Connor, it's best you stay here and help our man John Parker hold the town. It'll give us time to spread the word.
Stand your ground, men! Don't fire! Unless fired upon! But if they mean to have a war, let it begin here!
Pitcairn.
Disperse, you damn rebels! Lay down your arms and disperse!
What the deuce are you doing? Hold your position! Pray!
Ravens! Traitors!
They are not coming back. You will have to make do with those who remain.
Don't you lecture me, Yorna. Return fire! Return fire! You need to get to Concord and warn the others. Show this to whoever leads there. Should be a man by the name of James Barrett. Go on now!
Come on! We'll meet up with the others in Concord!
Get moving, men! With little time! And keep the pace! To Concord, lads!
Help! What's happening?
Get out! Everyone, run! They're taking prisoners! Run!
The Redcoats are taking captives!
We have to help!
Blood's been spilled in Lexington, and there's more to come. The regulars are on the march.
You don't say. And why do you think I'm men up here? Go home, or you get yourself killed. I've enough to worry about without some green boy looking to play at hero.
I can vouch for him.
John Parker as well. Where's Revere?
Captured.
What?
Fear not. That man's no stranger to sticky situations. He'll be fine. I'm sure of it.
Your lady's finished gossiping? Parker seems to believe you're not completely useless, so I suppose there's a thing or two you might be able to help with. When the fighting starts, we'll need to hold those positions there. They're critical to the defense of Concord. Good boys. Not used to soldiering, they need some with the experience to direct them. That's something you can do. You'd best be telling the truth.
You have my word.
Then I suppose all that's left to do is wait.
Sir! Man the barricades!
No! Ensure my men hold those positions. If the Red Devils break through, we're finished.
What would you have me do?
Listen carefully. The Redcoats will form firing lines. Order the men to shoot just before the line is ready. Too soon and they'll miss their targets. Too late, and the enemy will open fire first.
Understood.
And if any of those bastards make it through, engage them. You must keep my men alive.
Make ready!
Go!
Wait for my signal. Prepare yourselves. Make ready. Wait for the signal. Fire! Wait for the signal. Fire! Wait for my signal. Hold fire! Go! Make ready! Hold fire! Go! Make ready! Wait for the signal!
Fire now!
Hold fire! Fire! Hold fire!
Shoot!
Make ready! Go! Make ready! Go! Wait for the signal! Hold fire! Go! Wait for my signal! Wait for my signal!
Go!
Wait for the signal! Prepare yourself!
Open fire!
Make ready!
Shoot!
Prepare yourself!
Shoot!
Fall back! Fall back!
We did it! They're turning tail!
Takes a true monster to do something like this. At least they're gone.
I should have struck when I had the chance. Do you know where Pitcairn could have gone?
Back into the withered bosom of the British, no doubt. So that he may regroup and plan his next atrocity.
I need to find him. Every day I wait, more will suffer.
Chin up, friend. Many who should have died today now live because of you.
And what of them?
We do the best we can with what we've got.
It is not enough.
It never is.
For the support of the glorious cause, I beg they will accept my most cordial thanks for this distinguished testimony of their approbation. But lest some unlucky event should happen, unfavorable to my reputation, I beg it may be remembered by every gentleman in the room that I, this day, declare with utmost sincerity, I do not think myself equal to the command I am honored with.
Truly, there is no man better suited to the task.
Sir, I beg leave to assure the Congress that as no pecuniary consideration could have tempted me to have accepted this arduous employment,
do I know you?
I would not expect you to remember.
Come, Connor. There's someone I want you to meet.
I will keep an exact account of my expenses.
Sorry to pull you away like
that, but... Those, I doubt not, they will discharge.
The last thing we need is the two of you coming to blows. Now, Connor, allow me to introduce you to our newly appointed Commander-in-Chief, George Washington.
Ah,
So you're the one who saved Sam and John at Lexington.
It was the Patriots who did that. I merely lent support.
As humble as he is brave, we could use more men like you. I'm sorry, but if you'll excuse me, I should attend to Charles over there. He looks none too happy about being passed over for command. It was good to meet you, Connor.
Tell me you have news of Pitcairn.
I'm told he's taken shelter in Boston, where he's guarded by 1,000 redcoats. The only way you're gonna get at him is if we draw him out. Now, lucky for you, we're launching an offensive against the city in order to do just that. Israel Putnam has been given command of our forces. Present this to him, and he'll provide whatever aid you require. You'll find him at the encampment on Bunker Hill.
You have my thanks.
No need. It's the least I could do. Pitcairn's a dangerous man. The sooner we're rid of him, the better.
I would say the same of Charles Lee.
Now that's an altogether different beast. Let us leave it for another day. Best you head to Boston, Connor.
Hold and state your business!
I'm looking for Israel Putnam.
On whose orders?
Samuel Adams.
Follow me.
This is not Bunker Hill.
Aye, it's Breed's. There's been some disagreement as to where we should encamp.
Any news from Boston?
The Tories aren't moving. And any time we try to press them, we lose a dozen men. I think Putnam and the others plan to assemble artillery on these hills. A good shelling might make the Redcoats rethink their strategy.
And what of John Pitcairn?
That bastard's the cagiest of the bunch. He's appeared time to time to taunt us or send regards by way of cannon fire. It's all right, though. He'll have what's coming to him soon enough. Putnam's just up ahead. You can't miss.
I don't care much for your excuses. We should be building on Bunker Hill.
Breeds is closer to the city, but it is also closer to their art.
I rest my case. I'm going back to Bunker Hill. Good day, gentlemen.
General Putnam.
What?
I'm looking for John. I was told you'd be able to help me find him.
He's tucked away inside that city with no reason to leave. As long as that ship continues its assault, we'll never flush him out.
But if the ship was silenced...
Oh, then might be forced to get off his arse and come forward.
I shall fly this flag to signal my success.
And I shall speak fondly of you at your funeral.
Thank you.
As you say, better weapons, better training.
But I do not fear.
They lack in conviction and care, but not us. We have discipline, we have order, and most importantly, we have passion. We believe.
So maintain vigilance, conserve your ammo, ensure a proper line of sight. And above all else, men, do not fire until you see the whites of their eyes.
Well, I'll be damned. Did it.
That was quite a speech.
Lies, all of it, I'm afraid. Still, such words have carried us thus far.
And what of Pitcairn?
He's left Boston. As I said, he would. And set up camp on Molten Hill. There's no good way to get at him. Not with that maelstrom rolling down below. I suppose you could circle around a bit and wait for us to thin their ranks.
There is no time. I will have to chance a direct approach.
That's twice today you propose the impossible.
I see no other choice.
Not because you're mad as a March hare, son.
I expect an apology on my return.
Thank you.
Why? Why did you do this?
To protect Adams and Hancock and those they serve. You meant to kill them.
Kill them? Are you mad? I wanted only to parley. There was so much to discuss. To explain. You've put an end to that now.
If you speak true, then I will carry your last words to them.
They must lay down their arms. They must stop this war.
Why them and not the Redcoats?
Do you not think we ask the same question of the British? These things take time. And it would have succeeded had you let me play my part.
Part of the puppeteer.
Who better we hold the strings than another?
No, the strings should be severed. All should be free.
And we should live forever on castles in the sky. You wield your blade like a man, but your mouth like a child. And more will die now because of that.
Saho yonere ne o te nam da setakwe. Dini o ne yaho te na tam da setakwe.
Up on me like that.
Why don't you just go out there and just help this camp retreat? Don't ever do that again, you hear me?
God damn it!
General Putnam.
You live.
The same cannot be said for Pitcairn.
Well done, I suppose. But it matters little now. I'm ordering a full retreat. We have lost too many in exchange for too little. If the Tories want this hill so badly, let them have it. Boston is the true prize.
We have a bigger problem.
What do you mean?
This can't be right. It says they plan to murder Washington.
My enemy is tenacious. When money failed them, they took to force. But I have slain Johnson and Pitcairn both, ending their plots. George Washington now rallies the colonists, and their march towards freedom begins in earnest. Little wonder, then, that the Templars now want him dead. They seek to reshape this land into something cold and ordered, something soulless. And he is an obstacle. I must save him, that his cause can flourish and my people remain safe. But the more I prod, the greater the chance I am discovered. The Templars believe their men lost the revolution. In their eyes, the assassins are gone and scattered, no longer a threat. But I fear they will soon discover the truth, and me along with it. I must tread carefully.
How fares the hunt, Connor?
There is progress, but I worry it is not enough.
You must strike where you need it most. What if you pursued Charles Lee and your father? What then of Paul Revere and the soldiers at Lexington?
Soldiers? There were no soldiers in those towns, only men and women who were forced to defend themselves.
Is this not why you fight? To protect your people? Your struggle is the colonists' struggle. In helping one, you help the other.
Encouraging words from one who thought mine a fool's errand.
Make no mistake, I still do. But I can't help but feel some pride in your success.
And why should I give you any credit?
Then don't. But first, return the robe and the blade and the darts and all of the years of training and knowledge I have bestowed upon you. Return these, and then your words may have some merit.
Or you could just admit that you are wrong.
Oh, child, please, you've killed two men. One more salesman than soldier. You're gonna have to try a lot harder than that to impress me.
Is that so, old man? Or perhaps we should step outside. I will gladly demonstrate how easily I could trounce.
Connor, this is Benjamin Talmadge. His father was one of us, no need for secrecy. I think he has something he wants to say.
Achilles tells me you've uncovered a plot to murder the Commander-in-Chief.
Yes, but I have only false starts and dead ends to show for it.
Not anymore, my friend. Thomas Hickey's your man, and I aim to help you catch him.
How?
I'll explain on the way. You and I are going to New York.